Hello once again, my people. It is I, Veed, and welcome back to Temptations Ballad. Veed, why do you look like this? I'm a drag queen, that's why. Get used to it. For the next few episodes, get used to it. Last episode, we went into the library and we were learning about all of the, classes that come to, like, Dungeons & Dragons, and, Artemy was reading a little bit of a little something-something, and now, this episode, I'm probably gonna get demonetized. Let's get started. Technically, Cid never received the full Bonebreaker Guild / Tavern Tour experience since he was getting the living daylights beaten out of him while Hamish showed everyone around. Thus, it fell on Cole's shoulders to guide himself around the place. Thus it fell on Cole's shoulders to guide him around the place. That's what I meant. Most of the tour was fairly boring for the most part. Here's the main lobby, that's Papa's bedroom, and that's where we keep all the booze. And here are the supply closets. Cid scratched his head in confusion when he peered down the long, narrow hallway. Artemy mentioned this earlier. Why were you so insistent that she wasn't allowed down here? I think you hurt her feelings. Cole laughed with a sly smirk.
Listen, it was for her own good. A goody two-shoes like her would mentally evaporate if she found out what happens around here.
Why? Isn't this just a supply closet? You wrong, bitch. You a little bit wrong, but we'll leave you to that. He was interrupted by a loud moan and whimper from one of the closets, followed by rhythmic thumping. Big Mimi! Listen, don't get me into drag and don't get me drunk, because then I become this. I become Sarah Cream, and I'm sorry. Cid's eyes widened the size of dinner plates as realization slowly dawned on him.
Oh.
Okay, yeah, that makes sense. Cid shook his head furiously, though it would ward off the flush of red across his face.
Wait, so do the Bonebreakers come down to here to do it on a regular basis? I don't see any ladies in the guild so far.
Cole snickered at the badger's quickly deteriorating composure.
That's not a problem, since I'm pretty sure all the guys here are into dudes.
But wait, everyone here is gay? And you're all open and comfortable with that?
Cole clapped Cid on the shoulder with a grin.
You've got to own your truth, my man. If you like dudes, you like dudes. You know, there's no shame in that. Life's too short for guilty pleasures. Enjoy it to the fullest. And if someone is giving you trouble, Papa will personally give them a very persuasive conversation for you. Guild policy.
Cid spluttered and shuffled nervously.
That's really nice of Marrow. Not that I need it or anything.
Despite his words, Cid spared curious glances down the supply closet hallways.
I can't imagine being, like, so open about this kind of thing. How did this workplace tradition even start?
Oh, that's not what I wanted. Bye.
Sir?
Thank you.
When you're around scantily clad and horny men all day, I mean, this is just pretty much inevitable. When we return from long missions or jobs, a lot of Bonebreakers come here to let off some, like, steam. Papa encourages it too, says it's good for morale and team cohesion.
Cohesion. Girl, I don't know English.
I guess I can see the benefits.
I've messed with most of the guys here for one time or another. I mean, we used to allow it to fool around anywhere we wanted, even right in the lobby. But Hamish was a killjoy and said it was rude to guests and visitors, and now it's all restricted to supply closets and bath instead.
Cole gave a mournful sigh.
Things used to be, like, so fun.
It sounds like you guys still get plenty of, fun. A pink flesh-filled Sid's face and as another gleeful moan echoed from within the supply closet. Girl, just say that you want to fuck Cole. I'm dressed as a woman right now. If you want to fuck Cole, God. Just fucking do it. Just stick your dick inside him, okay? Stick his dick inside him, make him go, just do it. Just fucking do it. Cole smirks. Speaking of fun, you're an official bone breaker now. You're free to try out our little team building exercises too. If you're ever feeling pent up, just ask one of the guys in the tavern. I'm sure they'll be happy to help you out. Heck, some of them were eyeing you already. Sid spluttered furiously. What the? I couldn't possibly. God, that's probably a bad idea. I'm probably not even very good. I mean, I don't even have any experience with guys. Or anyone for that matter. Shh, it's not about being good. It's about having a good time and relaxing with your bros. This could be a good chance for you to build up some confidence. Heaven knows you need it.
Maybe? But I don't even know if I like guys.
A sly grin spread across Cole's nose exactly where he's going. He's like, why don't you fuck me? Why don't you get into this? Why don't you make this Sarah cream, honey? I didn't even think that I could use my name like that. But here we are using my name where it's like, make this Sarah fucking cream, honey. Like, do it. Well, you never know for sure unless you try it out, right? Is my fucking... Did I cut my finger? I think I cut my finger today. Oh, well, whatever. As Cole leaned forward with a wink, Sid stumbled backwards, his face glowing steadily redder. It was almost hilarious that a tiny guy like Cole could pin a giant like Sid across the wall with a suave grin. Come on, I've seen the way you've been eyeing me. You're at least a little curious, right?
Just show him his pussy.
I can't have drinks when I record. I can't. This is... Girl, I think I'm like partially a truly in. I've had 2 vodka crans and I've had 2 shots. Why did I think that this was going to be a good idea? Sid's ears drooped with guilt.
Sorry. I didn't mean to offend.
Ain't nothing to be sorry about. In fact, you should keep looking. If you're going to be a pervert, at least accept your own naughty feelings and enjoy them. Sid fidgeted with the hem of his shirt nervously while trying to ignore the growing heat across his face.
It's just... I've never really thought much about this kind of thing. Well, I mean, I guess I have, but I've never really acted on them before. Sorry, it's just hard to think straight right now.
I'll say there's nothing straight about this. It's all gay. It's all fucking flamboyant as shit. There's rainbows and pride flags and everything. Girl, just fuck each other. Do you want to start acting on those thoughts? I know you've gotten bullied for this kind of thing when you were young, but you might as well start reclaiming your feelings, right? I mean, they're not the boss of you. Cole smiled and gave Sid an encouraging pat on the shoulder. I'll be happy to help you out if you want to try exploring those feelings. No judgment or pressure or anything. Just putting the offer out there. Sid hesitated for a moment.
Well, I've always been a little curious about what it would feel like to be intimate.
Oh, you want to get intimate into this bliss?
I need to stop.
I'm single again, but I need to stop.
Cole grinned before grabbing the badger's hand, sensually guiding it down his abdomen toward his waist. You want to start exploring? I'm sure we can find an open supply closet for you. There was only a moment of uncertainty before Sid shyly nodded.
Sure. I mean, I think I'll give it a go.
Girl, you gonna
gonna get fucked today. Or you're gonna fuck. I think you're gonna fuck. Cole's gonna get fucked today because Cole's a little dirty little fucking I need to stop.
But only if you want to do it too. With a guy like me, I mean.
Cole could only laugh as he led Sid into a nearby closet with glee. You're so damn adorable. Do I cover with my face cam, and do I look at how busted I look right now? I haven't really looked at myself that much.
The butterflies in Sid's stomach only got worse when he closed the door behind him. His eyes darted from the dark corners of the closet to Cole's sympathetic grin to his own self-conscious position. Sid stood stiffly, with no idea where to put his hands.
So, where do we even start?
Well, first, you can take a deep breath and relax. Jeez, you look as scared as a kid on his first trip to the healers.
Cole's expression was both eager and gentle as he took a step towards him. The fluttering in Sid's stomach turned into a lurch. He yelped and stumbled, falling into his back with an embarrassing yelp. His heart was beating
much too fast for his comfort.
Sid shook his head vigorously.
He agreed to this. Stop getting so nervous about it.
He let out another yelp when the sensation of weight fell upon him.
Sure, Okoye, you got me fucked up. Alright, let's find out.
You know what's the funny thing? Because Shiro is always like, I can't fucking draw backgrounds. And it really shows. Girl, if you just practice backgrounds, I'm sure you're gonna be great because these look great. You know, for a supply closet, it looks great.
Sid whimpered as Cole grinded against his bulge with a teasing chuckle.
Well, it looks like you're already pretty excited about this, at least. How are you feeling, big guy?
Honestly? I don't think I've been more nervous in my life.
Deep breaths. Remember that I'm just here to help you out. Let me know if it gets too overwhelming and I'm giving you some space, okay? It is all about how you feel.
Heard Cole being a slutty, submissive bottom.
That's me! I'm the slutty bottom!
Sid sucked in a deep breath of air in an attempt to calm his racing heartbeat. Okay, this is just a new experience. Let me try and enjoy yourself. You know, despite the fact that Cole was literally sitting on his lap, his encouragement felt strangely comforting. Sid steadied himself and opened his eyes.
Okay. I think I'm ready to keep going.
Cole smiled patiently, his tail wagging with amusement.
Cool. Is there anything you wanted to try out?
Sid pondered for a moment before nervously stammering.
Well, I've always wondered what kissing... Girl...
I always wondered what kissing was like. Cole's eyebrow perked up in surprise. Sid found himself instantly muttering an apology.
Sorry. That's probably too mushy for this kind of thing.
Girl, you better stop with this. You know what? At least Cole isn't in leather right now, okay? Unlike Sissel in leather. Cue the scream right now.
No!
That did indeed happen. That happened when I was like 18 or 19. I am now 22.
Times changed.
I'm a slutty girl now.
Cole grinned and pressed a warm hand against his face, gently guiding his gaze towards him.
I've heard the badgers have long and talented tongues. Let's put that story to the test, shall we?
Shut the fuck up. Shut the fuck. I can't. Alexa, turn the lights up to 100%. Are you not gonna do it? Fine, I'll do it myself. Fine, I'll do it myself. Where's my phone? I'll do it myself. It always fucking happens. No matter what. It's always at like 2:30 or like 3 in the morning.
it always happens where, like, all of the lights just become, like, 10%, and I'm like, excuse me, I need a lot more light than that. Especially back here now, because you can't see any of my, posters, and I'm like, excuse me. Yes, 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 I know. Second bedroom. Bam. Thank you. Thank you very much. Okay. Now back to it. Shiro, you've got me fucked up like this. I'm not gonna block anything out because it's just kissing, it's not them fucking. Sid scarcely blinked before Cole enveloped his vision. His nervous stammers were stifled by soft lips as Cole pulled him close. After a moment of resistance, Sid leaned into the kiss with melted against with the warm sensation. Cole was surprisingly tender as he opened his lips, warm tongue gently lapping against the badger's in a teasing fashion. Sid suckled on the hyena's invading tongue and pushed deeper into his mouth, fully taking charge and exploring his intimate zest. I'm gonna be Shiro, if I can be 100% right now. I may be dressed as a woman right now, but I'm like half chub. Girl, I'm like half chub right now. You can't do this. Like, she's getting a little Tatiana, same parts. Period. He leaned into the kiss hungrily. His cock throbbed. I'm sorry, every single time that I'm not horny and I have to see something horny, I'm like, I just have to make jokes out of it. His cock throbbing in his pants. The warm and wet friction felt electrifying. As they deepened their kiss, his felt Cole's hands run teasingly down his shoulders and slowly undress his tunic. Warm fingers caressed his now bare chest. Sid let out a yell when he felt Cole pinch his sensitive nipples. And very hard, hard nipples.
And a 50% chance of very hard, hard nipples. So hard.
No, we're... Thank you. Do I block the... His whole ass is shown. I'm gonna... Just to be safe. Girl, just to be safe, I'm gonna block that whole shit. Now I get to see myself and how busted... You can see... You can see where my eyebrows were glued down. Oh no, call the police. Call the Endeavors. Sorry, I'm just getting rid of some of this hair that's... No, being covered a little bit. Sid finally broke the kiss with a gasping breath, the realization slowly dawning on him. His heart was racing. He had never been in such an intimate situation before. I look hot! Sorry, I'm like looking at myself in the viewfinder right now, and I'm like, girl, I'm the fucking... Hold on. Like, I've been seeing myself like this the whole night, and I'm like, girl, I'm fucking stunning. Like, girl, she's fucking getting it. And then I put on my glasses like this. Like she puts on her glasses and she's a sexy fucking librarian. Oh my god. Oh, I'm ready for my close-up, Mr. DeBoer. Yes. Honestly, call me your dirty little pig slut because I really can be your dirty little pig slut. I'm sorry, I just look hot. The heat was unbearable. At this point, his pants were uncomfortably tight with a bulging tent. Cole noticed and laughed.
You're pretty pent up, huh?
Sorry, you're a really good kisser.
You're not so bad yourself, big guy.
Well, I didn't actually do anything. You were in charge the whole time. Sorry, now that I'm seeing myself in the viewfinder, I'm like, you were in charge the whole time. I'm sorry, I just didn't... I'm such a... Wow, you can see how fucked up my arm is from all the death drops that I've been doing the past week. We're gonna hide that. Cole suddenly grinded his ass against his growing tent, forcing a shaking moan from Sid's throat. His pants felt painfully tight. Things were made all the worse by the sensation of Cole snuggling against his lap, rubbing hard against his bullshit cock. That friction and heat, not to mention the hyena's hands caressing. Am I loud enough? Probably not. Not to mention the hyena's hands caressing and squeezing his chest. Titties! Sid felt as though he was melting into a shivering puddle of pleasure in Cole's grip. He panted, eyes squeezed shut as he tried to catch his breath. The stimulation was overwhelming. His mind could scarcely process it. Sid's ears perked up as Cole's hands wandered lower and began drifting the hems of his pants. I should do drag more often when I'm playing video games. Let me know if you want more of this down below, because I will give it to you. Let's get this big guy some fresh air, shall we?
Wait, give me a sec.
The timid side of Sid's mind tried to protest, but the hyena's light rubs and touches felt too damn good.
Ah! Can you see?
Sorry.
No, you can't. Okay.
I need to send a message to a certain bitch. Hi. I'm in full drag right now. Sorry, I'm also recording. You cannot be fucking doing this to me right now. Shiro, I am going to call the authority. I am a woman, and I'm a hot librarian woman. I'm gonna call the authorities on you. Let's see what he says back. Time for full face cam. As soon as Cole pulled his shorts slightly, Sid's cock burst from its cloint restraints and twitched in the air, already dripping with pretty girl. I can fucking see that. I can already see that she's dripping with a little something, you know, a little bit of like a fountain, a little bit of like a lip it up, like. Oh my
god, I can't do this when I'm looking at myself in the viewfinder like this. But it's the only way to not get clocked from that. Unless I keep myself over here the whole fucking time. But that's not gonna fucking happen. Let's go.
I need to make sure my door was closed. I don't have a lock on my door this time.
Sid suddenly felt a wave of bashfulness flood over him as he tried to cover himself up. Was this all right?
His thoughts were interrupted by the sight of Cole's jaw dropping to the floor.
Holy. You're fucking huge. How did that even fit in your pants?
A hint of shame bubbled under Sid's chest as he self-consciously tried to cross his legs.
Sorry, I don't know how this works.
Sid's gonna be, you know what Sid's gonna be? Sid is literally going to be the...
I've never done this before.
And then, like, stick, like, a whole entire fucking, like, fucking traffic cone in his ass. Let me reenact it, just in case you need to. I'm drunk enough to reenact it. He's literally going to be, like, right here, and he's going to be like...
Oh no.
I look like a hot mess. This is not supposed to be seen in lighting, but it's like gonna be like,
oh no, I've never done this before. And then automatically, he's just gonna just like, and then like, take a whole entire traffic cone. Bowser, you're too good to be in this shot, okay? Stay there. But he's gonna be like, oh, you've never done this before. He's gonna be like, oh, you've never done this before. Oh my god. It's not big enough.
That's exactly what's gonna fucking happen. That is exactly what's gonna fucking happen, and you can't fucking tell me otherwise. Let's get back to it. How long is... It's already been half an hour.
Dude, what are you even apologizing for? This thing is a beaut. I can't believe you've been hiding this from me.
Huh?
Wait.
Huh?
His thoughts were cut short as Cole eagerly clawed down between his legs and hungrily looked on his face. With a hungry look on his face.
Girl, she's hungry and she's ready for the dick. Okay, she's ready to go 5,000.
I can't be in drag when I'm looking at porn, basically.
Because you're going to be like, I'm going to just like hide my hair back and I'm just going to like... It's gonna fucking happen at some point. Am I gonna have sex in drag? I better fucking not. Whoever decides to have sex with me in drag is gutted and needs therapy.
His thoughts were cut short as Cole eagerly crawled down between his legs with a hungry look on his face. The hyena laughed and gently gave Sid's throbbing meat a gentle stroke. Sid immediately shivered with a deep moan.
That didn't come out of my mouth. I don't know what you're talking about.
Oh, you're pretty sensitive down here, aren't you? Oh, this is gonna be fun.
Cole leaned forward and gave the leaking cocktip a cocktip. Work, bitch. Did he message me? He did not. He's probably asleep. And gave the leaking cocktip a gentle lick.
Sid let out a gasp, legs shaking.
Wee's meek arms are heavy. He's fallen on his sudden already. Mom, spaghetti, he dropped bombs.
The heat of Cole's tongue against his sensitive tip made his mind almost blank out of pleasure. His head fell back and jaws hung open.
Sid fully lost all sense of the word as he panted heavily. The only thing his mind was aware of was the sensation of Cole's hot tongue, dragging lazy, teasing circles around the tip of his quivering dick.
My pants are on. YouTube, don't take me the fuck down. I've already had TikTok take me down. Don't take me down, YouTube. I promise I've been a good boy.
He whimpered and gave a few quivering humps against Cole's open maw.
I don't want to save.
Oh, it's because of this fucking hair strand, probably. Cole laughed, one hand trailing downwards to caress his Sid's hair. His gentle touch just made Sid twitch harder with pleasure. He felt like he was gonna burst!
That was my neck.
I might not last much longer.
Was this good? This was his first time doing this sort of thing. Sex usually lasted longer than this, didn't it? Was Cole going to laugh? The small hyena only smirked and leaned forward.
I have to block this whole fucking screen, bitch.
Shiro, you got me fucked up. I hate you. Like, I love you, but like, I hate you. The fuck?
His open maw wrapped fully around Sid's aching cock, enveloped it with its hot, wet embrace. Sid nearly blacked out from the sheer pleasure and overstimulation. His body writhed on the floor as Cole continued to suckle on his sensitive cup. Tongue swirling deliciously against his flesh. Sid's coat curled and body shook as he struggled to keep his vision steady. He weakly thrusted against Cole's maw with trembling hips, his orgasm threatening ever closer. Cole, I'm gonna... Bitch, I need to put on some fucking gloss because, girl, I'm thirsty for that dick too! I'm a little bit... Girl, she's looking like a fountain, and let me tell you, she's probably gonna be a little bit thirsty. A little bit thirsty! Girl, you can't have me like this. You can't have me like this. I swear to fucking God. Sid let out a strained howl as the dam broke and pleasure flooded his body in a storm. Rope after rope of cum erupted from his cock, soaking over his chest and face. Cole pumped his length eagerly to milk him further. She said milk. She did not want to waste a fucking drop. She's not storing it for next Christmas. She's getting it out right now. Sid's cock twitched with his grip as the fountain slowly died down to a trickle as the badger was left in a breathless, shaking mess. So when are they gonna fuck? When are they gonna fuck, Shiro? His lung rasped for air. Sid closed his eyes, head hanging back from the on the floor as he rode out the afterglow of his overwhelming orgasm. He could hear Cole chuckle and the hyena climbed over him and gave him a cheerful smooch on the cheek. Well, did you enjoy your first Bonebreaker welcome session? Sid could only nod his head weakly, still shaking from the experience. That was... He breathed deeply and let out a shy laugh. That was really nice. Thank you. Betcha, he was probably going to be like, we ain't done yet, bitch. We ain't done yet. That needs to go inside. Girl, my eyebrows are fading out, and then I'm here like, she's gonna go inside. Like, she's gonna go inside that pussy. Aw, you're too damn sweet. Always happy to help a guy get in touch with his inner pervert. Cole licked his lips and patted Sid on the head. Sid finally opened his eyes, vision still blurry. He turned towards Cole with a timid smile. But... you did all the work here. They are gonna fuck. Oh my God, I look so fat whenever I do this, but it's honestly giving me like Alyssa Edwards. I have leftover glue on my lash. I'm still here for it. Shouldn't I help you out a bit too? Cole laughed. Wow, I didn't expect for you to be such a gentleman. Don't worry about it, big guy. I just want to help you get comfortable with yourself today. No need to worry about me. Cole, you best take that dick inside you. That's my favorite thing to do now since, like, this is a lace front wig and I have her pinned. So I got, like, I could do, like, helicopters. So I'm like, let him fuck you, bitch. Like, I swear to fucking God. Do it. I need my brush. You can barely even lift your head right now anyway. Cole gave the badger's overstimulated cock a teasing stroke. Sid yelped and shivered in exhaustion. We can put this bad boy to use another time. Sid flushed and nod, but nodded quietly. I don't mind trying it out. Thanks, boss. That's it, girl. I'm upset.
Girl, if I'm here for porn, I'm gonna be here for porn. And he did not stick it up that tiny little fucking punani. Okay, not in like this inside of this fucking punani. Not like this fucking punani, bitch. Not inside of the, this punani. Like,
what am I here for? I'm already demonetized from this video. What am I here for? What is she doing? What is her purpose? You best tell me that right the fuck now.
Girl, bye.
Fun. I'm gonna go back on this screen, and I'm gonna call it an episode. Thank you all so much for watching. My name's Veed. I hope they had a wonderful time watching this. I hope they had a wonderful time watching me watch porn and not see it get stuck in the pussy. Make sure to hit that like, comment, subscribe button down below, and I hope a fellow YouTuber out. Make sure to hit that notification bell so no way to miss about any of my uploads, and I will see you in the next episode. Goodbye.